Hello, people. We are at it again, talking about Linux. I'm going to angry you guys because there are people out there in the great, amazing Linux community losing their tits, balls, buttholes, arms, eyes, brains over this little thing that you see right here called Linux, or not Linux, but Ubuntu Pro. Oh, sorry, Ubuntu Pro. Stupid idiot here. Some great OS. Same great OS, more security updates. People are like, oh my god, now we have to pay for blah, 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 blah. For updating Ubuntu and so on and so on. Really not. This has nothing to do with the desktop. This is not for you. If you're running Ubuntu as a Plex server, if you're running Ubuntu at home instead of Windows, this little thing over here, you just open your brain, take it out and throw it away. This is something that has been demanded for fucking years, okay? This is why I love the Linux community, okay? I am like, go into my fucking nerd brain. They want something, they get it, they're not satisfied. It's like this fucking girlfriend, no matter where the fuck you take her out for dinner, she always bitching about something. She always wants to talk to the manager. It's like the Karens are fucking girlfriends. The Linux community is built up with Karens. They are never satisfied. They always want to fucking bitch about something. Let's dive into what Ubuntu Pro actually is, because most people have not actually read what it's all about. I've heard about this, well, not heard about it, but the idea about this has been around for fucking ages, okay? It's just never been implemented correctly. But let's look at it here. 10 years security coverage. This first thing here should make your intelligent brain that you guys have that I don't have be like, ding! Because Ubuntu Pro, currently in public beta, expands our famous 10-year security coverage to an additionally 23,000 packages beyond the main operating system. Ubuntu Pro expands our famous 10-year security coverage to an additional 23,000 packages beyond the main operating system, including Ansible, Apache Tomcat, Apache Zookeeper. Great movie, by the way. Docker, Drupal, Negeos, Node.js, PHP MyAdmin, Puppet, PowerDNS, Python 2, Redis, Rust, WordPress, and many more. What have all of these have in common? They are used on servers and in corporate environments. So Ubuntu Pro is for people in the corporate world that want to get additional security fixes for, let's say, outdated software. So let's say you like Python 2, nobody really, well, it's outphased. There are people still using it. So that was my mistake saying that nobody will use it. There are still a lot of people using Python 2. There's still a lot of programs built in Python 2. So if you're running, let's say, Ubuntu 18.04, I think that's the earliest one that get this Ubuntu Pro accessibility. So if you're running 18.04 and you're running Python 2, Ubuntu will help make sure that your Ubuntu distribution with Python 2 is secure. You pay them to make sure that the corporate software, the software used in corporate environments, are secure outside of its own life cycle. Like I said, I think Python 2 is only in maintenance or something like that. I could be mistaken, but I don't think Ubuntu is maintaining it anymore, well, officially maintaining it anymore. So if you are running Python 2 or other software, they help you make sure that it's up to date. Get what I'm saying here? It's an extra security for people that want to make sure that their software is extra secure and up to date with the security patches and so on. It don't mean that you will not get security patches for Python 3 now. Don't mean that Ansible under Ubuntu 22.04 is not getting security updates. What it will mean is that they are extending those security updates, you know, for Ansible, Tomcat, Apache, Puppet, Python 2, alongside, you know, the official lifespan of the distribution or security update lifespan of said Ubuntu version. So when you are, or if you are running a Ubuntu version that's 10 years old, the software that you're running in there also still will be getting extra security updates to make sure that your environment in your corporate world is set up as a fucking amazing chef kiss to security world. This is a good thing. Why is it paid? Well, you want something, you pay for it. The community is not going to maintain this. Where's the security or the community? Can this be done for free? Yeah, if you guys and girls out there roll up your fucking sleeves and get to work, then it can be done. But the thing is, the community is all fucking bullshit in a lot of instances because they are not doing it. They are not taking up the mantle to maintain it. Some are in some instances, but for the most part, they are not. So Ubuntu have to actually get people to do it. How do they do that? By paying them a fucking salary, okay? Why are you getting paid for it? Also because it's in the corporate world. They need somewhere to bitch and moan if things don't go right. Free for personal use. So if you have a machine that are running these, you know, you're using it as your home server, your NAS server, and blah, 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 you can do it for free. And here you can see what the difference is. So you can see here, this is actually really, really interesting. Security pattern covered for both critical high and selected medium CVSs. What's the difference here? So in the Ubuntu's LTS, you only get 5 years over 2,300 packages in the main repository and over 23,000 packages in the universe repositories. But in the universe, in the LTS, it's best effort. With the Pro Info only, you get 10 years with the main repository at best effort with the universe. With Pro, you get 10 years with the main repository and universe. So it's extending the security patches basically for the programs in there, which is great for you. You can go ahead and read more about it. This is done by demand, okay? There is a demand for it. That's why they did it. I've seen people make comments like, oh, it's just Ubuntu wants to nickel and dime us and blah, blah, blah. No, it's actually been a demand for a long ass time. Like a long, 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 long time by the corporate world. That they want, let's just call it, outdated software to be security maintained for longer. Because here's the thing with the corporate world that you guys and girls out there apparently don't know, is that they don't just update every time there's a new update. If there's no benefit for them to updating and everything is working and stable and stuff like that, they really don't want to update. They really want to just sit where it is. They're still fucking, you know, Windows XP machines out there in the world. There are still Windows 95 machines out there in the world because it works. And if they update it and there's just one bug, that means the loss of billions of dollars. So as long as this machine is ticking and it's working, okay, and stuff like that, and it's secure, let's not fucking mess with it. Because if we update this old of a machine, we don't know what kind of fucking crazy shit we're going to introduce into our system. So this is working right now. It's secure. Let's just leave it be, you know. Don't fiddle too much with it. So and I think it comes from the whole the Arch Linux users mentality that they want the latest and greatest here now. In a corporate world, you don't really need the latest and greatest. You don't really need the newest features. You don't need the newest, you know, additions to a software if you're not going to use it. The corporate world actually works a lot like I wish most consumers would be working, is that, do I need this? Just because it says a new version number and I get new shiny things, but do I really need it? Is it something that's going to benefit me? And a lot of times, no. Is it nice to have things? Probably. But look at the kernel. Most of the things being updated in the kernel is something that you will never be using because you're not running on MySQL server or Apache server and stuff like, or any corporate software. You're just running this as a desktop. So most of the updates to the new kernel versions you are not going to use other than the hardware support, if you have said hardware. The corporate world don't change hardware that much. They don't change software that much. They don't change operating system that much. They don't update that much. So they want to make sure that they can buy basically support from a company that can handle the security aspect or the patching for them. So they don't have to be afraid of there is a critical bug in Python 2 or in Rust on the 18.04 or 15.04 version of Ubuntu, however long they go back. because Ubuntu is not maintaining it anymore, and the package, the original package maintainer, is not maintaining it anymore. Therefore, the community is just like, forget about that shit and not maintaining it anymore. So they want to make sure that we don't want to upgrade just to make sure that we get security patches, because that's the only reason why we should update, is to get security packages from Python. We don't need Python 3. Everything we do is in Python 2. We don't need the new features in Python 3. We have legacy software that's done in Python 3 that is used by hundreds of thousands and maybe just billions of dollars. We don't need to change the whole fucking million lines of code just to go to Python 3 so we can get support forward and security fixes forward. So that's why we have Ubuntu Pro. It's for those people. It's not for you. It's not for you to go crazy over. I fucking love this. I love this. I love it so much. This is giving people an opportunity to have their current environment for an extra long time. How is that a bad idea? This is not Ubuntu trying to become Microsoft. I heard this a fucking lot. No. This is a company making a company decision based on consumer demands. So if you want to be angry about someone, be angry at the people using Ubuntu server that have asked for these kind of things. Those are the ones you should be angry about, not Canonical. Because Canonical is just doing what the consumers want. Like I said, this has been in demand and been asked for years if Ubuntu wants to extend their lifecycle security patching for their operating systems and their software. Now they are responding to it. And of course, like anything else in this world, nothing is free. They need to pay developers. They need to pay people to do this for them. So who is going to pay that bill? You as a customer. And here's the thing. The corporate world don't care about spending an extra $1,000 a month or a year for something like this, because they're probably making 100 times that by running this software. You get what I'm trying to say here. See you all later. Bye-bye.